then coming to the next concept, that is called the Poisson's law derivation. So in this Poisson's law derivation, so we are finding the breakdown voltage. Okay, by using Poisson's law, we are finding the minimum breakdown voltage, that is called a VB minimum. Okay, so VB minimum we are finding by using Poisson's law curve. By using Poisson's curve, we are finding VB minimum and the rest PD minimum. Okay, the breakdown at which the PD minimum we are finding. Okay, so this is called the Poisson's curve. So we are finding. So VB minimum breakdown voltage, VB minimum. Okay, with respect to the PD minimum. Okay, so when the distances goes on decreasing like this, or pressure goes on decreasing like this manner, this breakdown voltage also decreasing. So we are finding the minimum breakdown condition with respect to the PD minimum. Okay, so there are two types of points we are taken. One is called A and B. So here A is the at point A and B, this path is up here across the gas. Okay, that's why we are taken two points in this curve of the Poisson's curve. On Poisson's curve, we are taken two points, that is called A and B. So based on that, we are finding the minimum breakdown voltage and PD minimum also. Okay, so in this first we will discuss limitations of Poisson's law. So still applicable for only uniform field. Same as Townsend's theory. Is applicable for only uniform field. Not applicable for non-uniform field. It's only applicable for uniform field. Okay, not applicable for non-uniform electric field. Applicable for only uniform electric fields, not applicable for non-uniform electric fields. And greater than 1,100 degrees Celsius fails to apply due to some thermionic emissions and electrode discharge. This is also one of the drawback. The temperature increasing, goes on increasing, the Poisson's law is not valid. So to apply the, to find the breakdown voltage of the electrode material. So that is the problem we are facing. So when temperature increasing between two electrodes, and next only for certain gas, that means nitrogen, SF6, hydrogen, carbon dioxide. So only for certain gases, the Poisson's law eligible, is valid. But some other gases, combination of some other gases, that is called argon neon. Okay, argon neon. Combination of gases of this this Poisson's law is not valid. So if you are applying the finding the measure to find the minimum breakdown of the those gases, combination of two, three gases. So the Poisson's law is not explained. We are not getting exactly results. We are taking two, three combinations of gases. Okay, that is the problem in basis of gases. Next, applicable only for Townsend's breakdown criterion. Okay, based on the Townsend's criterion, so we are finding different minimum breakdown voltage. So only one drawback of Townsend's breakdown is not explained by considering the pressure. Okay, secondary ionization, primary ionization, that without considering the pressure is explained breakdown of the gases. So that is the problem. That problem can be overcome by using Poisson's law, but is considering pressure and distance is explained dielectric breakdown of insulated gas. So it's derived one formula based on that alpha minus eta is equal to m1 by gamma plus alpha minus eta by alpha plus 1. Here alpha is called Townsend's primary ionization coefficient and gamma is called Townsend's secondary ionization coefficient, and eta is called electron attachment coefficient. Yeah. So these are the three, four different types of limitations of Poisson's law. Next, experiment expression for PD minimum and VB minimum. By using Townsend's criterion, we are finding PD minimum and VB minimum. Okay. So we know well, by using Townsend's theory, we found it, already we are derived this expression. Okay, I is equal to I naught in t power alpha d by 1 minus gamma in t power alpha d minus 1. According to the Townsend's secondary ionization theory, we are getting like it. During the breakdown condition, the current is infinity. That means ideally infinity, practically maximum current, whatever the current supplied by the source, that current is equal to the current flowing to the dielectric material. Okay, actually the insulator is not allowing current, but we are applying high voltage, no? when you are applying the high voltage means that a insulator will be acting as a, instead of acting as insulator, it will be acting as a conductor at that condition. So the current is high, very high. So that's why we are taking the infinity. Okay. The current is limited by using external resistance, therefore it's called limiting resistor. One of the limiting resistor is there, current limiting resistor is there. But ideally we are using we are assuming infinity current. That's it. 1/0. We are substituting here 1/0, we are getting A naught into e power alpha d by 1 minus gamma into e power alpha d minus 1. Then cross multiply these two, we will get 1 minus gamma into e power alpha d minus 1 is equal to 0, and then gamma into e power alpha d minus 1 is equal to 1, and then so we are getting the condition expression like this. So we are this equation considered as 1. Understand alpha and gamma in terms of field and pressure. So we are taking field and pressure. So that alpha by P is equal to, that is called, according to the primary Thomson's criterion, alpha by P is equal to F1 of E by P. Primary energy coefficient to the pressure is nothing but a function of like field and pressure. So like that, we are, according to the Thomson's theory, we are taking alpha by P is equal to F1 of E by P. So we know, well, electric field E is equal to V by D, voltage by breakdown voltage by distance. You know, substitute this breakdown voltage here, and alpha by P is equal to F1 of E by P. No? So E is equal to V by D, substitute here, V by P into D. Then alpha is equal to P into F1 of V by P D. So you consider the second equation. And then gamma is also a function of electric field and pressure P. Electric field E and the pressure P, gamma, secondary energy coefficient gamma is also a function of electric field E and the pressure P, same as primary energy coefficient alpha is a function of electric field and pressure. Same here also, gamma is a function of electric field and pressure. Gamma is equal to F2 of, substitute here, E is equal to V by D in this equation. So we'll get gamma is equal to F2 of V by PD, that's called three. The two and the three equations are substituted in equation one. This equation, gamma in d power alpha d minus 1 is equal to 1. Substitute in this equation, so we are getting like this. So gamma is equal to f2 of e by pd. Substitute here, gamma is equal to f2 of e by pd, and e power gamma into d, alpha into d, e power alpha into d. Substitute here alpha, nothing but f1 of p into f1 of v by pd. Substitute here, like that you are getting. Okay, and e power p into f1 into v by pd minus 1. Okay, so alpha into d minus 1. So here, e power alpha into d. Right, e power alpha into d. So alpha is nothing but p into f1 into v by pd and into t. So alpha, one more is there. T is also there. Okay, f2 of v by pd. And then E power P into F1 of E by PD, gamma into D is minus 1 is equal to 1. So by looking this expression, this function is always is a function of pressure and a distance. From the above equation, we can say that the voltage is a function of pressure and a distance. The voltage is a function of pressure and a distance. This is called Passage's law. According to the Passage's law, we are finding the relation between pressure and distance. So like that, we are getting an expression. Then up to here, we are completed Passage's law derivation. We are expressing voltage in the function of V and D. V is called a breakdown voltage. Okay. And then coming to the next determination of minimum breakdown voltage, VB minimum and PD minimum. Okay. So VB minimum and PD minimum by using Passage's law. So we know that I is equal to I naught in d power alpha d by 1 minus gamma into e power alpha d minus 1 under breakdown condition. So infinity, current is infinity. 1 minus gamma into e power alpha d minus 1 is equal to 0. Now substitute here and then we are getting like this. Okay. And gamma into e power alpha d minus 1 is equal to 1 and gamma into e power alpha d is equal to 1 plus gamma. Simplify this expression, we are getting like this. E power alpha d is equal to 1 plus 1 by gamma. So this is the equation 1. And the next one, alpha by p is equal to a function of E by P. Primary energy coefficient is a function of electric field and pressure. So alpha is equal to p into f and f of e by p. Okay, substitute 2 in equation 1, we are getting. So substitute this 2. Substitute 2, this called second equation, substitute in equation 1. So we are getting like this. So by substituting this alpha, this here alpha is there. Okay, e power something we are getting like that. E power d into p into f into e by p is equal to 1 plus 1 by comma. So like that we are getting. Okay, by substituting alpha. Taking ln on both sides. Okay, and then ln of e power d p f of e by p is equal to ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma. We are ready. And then pdf is equal to pd function of e by p is equal to ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma. So the gamma is called constant, secondary energy quotient constant. Okay, then ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma is also constant. Okay, under uniform field, E is equal to V by D. Under uniform electric field. So this Poisson's law is also not valid for Poisson's law, not valid for not uniform field, non uniform field is only valid for uniform field. That is the way I'm already explained. For uniform field, E is equal to V by D. Substitute here and we are getting like that. Function of E is equal to V by D, V by D, and V by D into P into PD. So this is PD, same here. So, okay. We are looking like that. Then f of function of EBB by PD is equal to k by PD. No? So then coming to the right side is denominator. Then breakdown voltage is the function of pressure and distance. This is called Poisson's law. We are completed up to here with the Poisson's law derivation. Then next, by using Poisson's curve, we are finding the minimum breakdown voltage and PD minimum. Okay. So you have taken P, B, one point B, and this curve. At which this point, this spark is occur on the gas. Okay. So VB minimum, this is VB minimum, and PD minimum. This is exponentially decaying. This is exponentially decaying. Okay. Curve is like it. Okay. So like this. Is exponentially decaying, that's why we are taking alpha b is function of a, okay, alpha b is called primary energy coefficient to the pressure is a function of exponential formula, so it is called empirical formula, analytical expression, okay, minimum spark potential, that is alpha by p is equal to e into e power minus bb by e, substitute e is equal to bb by d in this equation, so, okay, so alpha by p is equal to e into e power minus E is equal to V by D no? Minus B by BB by D. So, and then, so E power minus, no? So that will become like this 1 by E power minus means 1 by A by E power B, B, P, D by BB. So when it comes to denominator like this, and this alpha is come like this in the right side. So, like this we are getting. Okay. E power B, P, D by BB by PA is equal to 1 by alpha. Then multiply on both sides, multiply on numerator and denominator d. So d by 1 by alpha d. So we are getting like this. So e power b p d by v b by p a is equal to, we are getting like this. Okay. And then I is equal to I naught into e power alpha d. You know well. Alpha d by 1 minus gamma d for alpha d minus 1. Under breakdown condition, we are getting this type of expression. Substituting 1 by 0, gamma d for alpha d is equal to 1 plus gamma, e for alpha d is equal to 1 plus 1 by. Apply both sides, ln log, take a log both sides. Ln of e for alpha d is equal to 1 plus 1 by gamma. So, like that, alpha d is equal to ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma. Then d is equal to substitute this alpha d is already here. In this equation. Substitute this alpha d. So in this equation, okay, you are getting d. So distance d is equal to e power b p d by b p by p a is equal to ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma. Okay, like that you are getting. And then assume gamma is constant, the ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma is constant k. Okay, if you are considering gamma is constant, secondary energy coefficient is constant, means gamma is around 1 plus 1 by gamma is also constant. Then D is equal to e power PD by PB by PA into K. It's called constant K. So that's why you are taking K. And the next PAD by K is equal to e power BPD by BB. So we are getting, we are simplifying like this. As apply both sides, ln and ln of PD by K is equal to ln P exponential is cancelled and then it will become BPD by BB. So this is the expression we are getting. Okay. And differentiating VB with respect to PD and EPD into zero, we are getting a condition for VB minimum, at which the maximum breakdown occur. That is called at which the maximum breakdown occur. We are finding, or to find means, by differentiating this equation, this is called VB expression. So VB is equal to BPD by ln of EPD by K. Here VB on left side, then we are getting like that. VB is equal to BPD by ln of APD by K. Here we are getting like this. Right? And then differentiate this expression with respect to PD. Here, why we are taking PD means PD is variable. Okay. So, questions go. PD is variable. So, maximum to minimum and minimum to maximum. Distance varying, pressure is varying. So, because of that, PD is a result also varying. That's why we are taking PD with differentiate with respect to variable. That is called PD. So, dB by dPD into VB is equal to 0. U by V, so you don't know when. U by V. So, U by V now. Is a function of, so ln of APD by V into U dash minus U into V dash by V square is equal to 0. So like that, we're deriving this expression. We are getting like this. And then ln of APD by K is equal to 1. We are getting simplify this expression. We will get like this. Ln of APD by K is equal to 1. And ln of APD by K is equal to 1 means ln of E is nothing but 1. So APD by K is equal to E. And then PD minimum is equal to E by A into K. So like that. This is the condition for minimum condition for breakdown voltage, minimum breakdown voltage, that is the PD minimum. PD minimum is equal to E by A into K. So E is nothing but 2.718, E is equal to 2.718, and A is called one constant, and K is called constant, that is called ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma. Substitute here K, K is equal to ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma. So we are getting. So like this, so PD minimum is equal to, so E is equal to 2.718, am I right? 2.718 divided by A, na? So same A. And then K is equal to ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma, ln of, so we are getting like this, 1 plus final expression. So PD minimum is equal to here. PD minimum is equal to E by A into K. So E is nothing but 2.718 by A is equal to K is equal to ln of K is equal to ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma. So we are assuming like this. So substitute here. So then we are getting the final expression. PD minimum is equal to E by A into K. E by A is nothing but 2.718 by A is nothing but A ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma. So like that we are getting. PD minimum. By substituting the PD minimum in this expression, we will get VB minimum. Okay, so VB minimum is equal to P into PD minimum by ln of APD by APD minimum by K. So in this expression, so we are finding. Okay, so VB minimum, PD minimum, we are getting PD minimum, I am differentiating equal to 0 and we are getting PD minimum. Substitute that PD minimum in this expression, we will get VB minimum. Okay. So VB minimum is equal to like that we are getting. Okay. And so by substituting the VB PD minimum, so the minimum breakdown voltage. So like that we are getting. So this is the final expression. VB minimum is equal to B into 2.718 is nothing but 2.718 by A into ln of 1 plus 1 by gamma. So, okay. So in this way we are finding VB minimum and the PD minimum by using Pascal's law. Okay, so this is about derivation and of Pascal's law. So next class we will discuss next session we will discuss problems regarding the taxes by using PDB loan and PDB. Okay, right.